zoning referral to the council, if we could read that into the record?
Sure, the city council referral regarding a request by Concord Orthopedic to rezone portions of the medium density residential district along Pleasant Street to the institutional IS district.
Okay, is the applicant here? Come on up. Oh boy, a whole case.
All right, a whole case, I just need to pass it up. Good evening, I'm Bob Carey, on behalf of the applicant, and with me is Dr. Peter Dorsey, and we pass that some. Copy of this, minor to the neighbors. I gave an extra copy, but I do one more.
I gave one to Mr. Ryan.
I'm Bob Carey, and I'm from the law firm of Warren Reno, and I'm here on behalf of the applicant, Concord Orthopedics. This is a recommendation, or it is here for recommendation for application to rezone 1/3 of a mile of Pleasant Street with 2029. Concord Orthopedics wants to build a state-of-the-art day surgery center on its property of 297 Pleasant Street. This property is in the medium density residential district, which is why we are here with this application. I'm going to show you an overview of the area that's at issue here. And if you, the purple districts are the institutional districts. And the star closest to the IS is where Concord Orthopedics is now. And the star that is in the light green shaded district is the residential, medium density residential district. And that star is 297 Pleasant Street, which Concord Orthopedics owns. And this is the district that is this at issue with this application. I'm going to refer to Concord Orthopedics proposal as Plan 1, and that is a plan to rezone the entire district. There is a recommendation by the city planner that is in your materials, and it is at tab 2, and that is to consider a smaller rezone of 3 parcels, and I'll refer to that as Plan 2, and as I go through my remarks tonight, I'll contrast both of them and explain how what impacts, different impacts the Plan 1 and Plan 2 may have on the factors you need to consider. And I'll review the factors that you need to consider under the zoning ordinance. The 3 main reasons, these coalesce around those factors too, why we are in favor, why we're urging you to recommend either Plan 1 or Plan 2. Is that this day surgery center is good for the patients of Concord Orthopedics. Dr. Norsey will talk with you about the trend and future of orthopedic surgery. The State Surgery Center will allow Conquer Orthopedics to have a specialized facility that can do total joint procedures on a health patient basis, in addition to other orthopedic procedures. The second reason is we think the rezoning proposal, either under Plan 1 or Plan 2, is good for the greater community. Great medical care is something that puts Concord on the map. It's something that we're fortunate to have. Not a lot of other communities enjoy that benefit, and a lot of communities are having a harder time in Concord. Concord Hospital is the biggest private employer in the city. It brings good jobs to the city. Concord Orthopedics is a vital part of the success Concord Hospital enjoys, and a vital part of the success of the medical community that puts Concord on the map. And so we believe that there is a significant greater good to this proposal as well. The third thing that I'm going to discuss and we think recommend is use either plan is the impact that the Day Surgery Center would have on the neighborhood. Concord Orthopedics has spent a lot of time and money to come up with a site-sensitive plan and preserves the existing structures on the site. There's an old red barn and there's a house there. Those would be preserved. And the streetscape would be preserved. And as I'll show you in a moment how the plans can accommodate that. So it's a good thing. A very good thing that we're having this discussion because we have a successful local business that needs to and wants to expand and grow here in Concord. And that's a good debate to have. Not every community that's fortunate to have that discussion. So this is the sort of Goodyear blimp view. Let me go down to what I'm going to call Plan 1, and that is our subject of our application. This is a close-up view of that residential, medium-density residential district, the RM district. 297 is the third one in from the left from the bottom. As you can see, this district is sandwiched between two institutional districts. And the city planner's memo does an excellent job of describing the history of this district. For approximately 30 years, from late 60s to 2001, this kind of use was permitted by special exception in this zone. In 2001, the zone was changed, and there was some, Ms. Shanks Melwood discusses, there was some confusion or mystery as to why that zone was changed, and there was a recommendation to make it institutional so that a use such as this could be permitted by a special exception. This is Concord's medical hub. This is where the Concord Hospital has grown and grown considerably. This is where Concord Orthopedics has grown and grown considerably. And you can see the other institutional medical uses in this district. Dartmouth Hitchcock has property that they're not using currently. Riverbend is there. Quest Diagnostic is there. Pleasant Street Family Medicine is there. We think Plan 1 makes sense from a long-term planning perspective. The medical community is growing and needs to grow. Concord Orthopedics has an immediate need, but they're not the only ones. And if you look at tab 10 of the materials, there's a letter from the GI group that talks about their needs to expand. And we've heard other practice groups that are also looking for space and can't find it in Concord Hospital. The Plan 1 does allow the district to evolve in a planned way. You can plan for expansion. But it does commit the city to this being the center of, or the medical corridor. Because in the long term, if it's institutional, I think it's going to be attractive to other medical practices as well. So that's something to consider. Plan 2 which is in Ms. Shank's memo as a recommendation for this board to consider, is a smaller rezone. It's a three-lot rezone. One of those lots, 307, is the one that is currently used residentially. The Ryder family owns the parcel and has owned it for some time. This would let Concord Orthopedics build the day surgery center it needs, but it would also buy time for the bigger debate to play out as to where other medical practices will expand and where the city wants them to expand. Plan two buys the city time to address that issue, while at the same time accommodating Concord Orthopedics immediately. Among the main differences between Plan 1 and Plan 2, Plan 1 rezones three properties, nine of which are used residentially now. Plan 2 rezones three properties, one of which is used residentially now. This, as you may know, is not the most popular proposal that the city has seen. And I'd like to later on in my remarks talk about what I think the benefits are of this proposal, but I do want to deal right up front with the objections that have been raised to it. The objections that have been raised to it, the concerns that have been raised to it, really coalesce around the impact that it would have on the neighborhood. There's a lot of other factors that play to that, but that's the central theme as to what, as to the objections to it. This is, if you're familiar with this neighborhood, it's a good neighborhood. These are well cared for properties. These homes look nice, they're kept up. The people who live here take a lot of pride in how the neighborhood looks. Through the various meetings we've had, TPAC, EDAC, all kinds of meetings, I've met a lot of the people who live here, and they are good people. They are good citizens and care about where they live, and it shows. As I mentioned, this district, to help you understand sort of the frame, the objections and concerns, this district is a mixed-use district. It is right in the middle and sandwiched between two institutional districts. Even within the district, you have the Birches, which is an institutional use, I would say, and you have two parcels owned by St. Paul's, which are institutional. It's an institutional owner, and across the street from the parcels on the sort of, I would say, the east side of the district, they look across at Riverbend, at the Unitarian Church, at Russell Animal Hospital, and other long-term, long-standing institutional uses. And in that third of a mile, that's the reality of what this mixed use looks like. In 2013, the owner of the property we purchased at 297, the Webster Trust, was trying to sell the property and applied for a variance. And that's at tab 5 of your materials. And if you look at page 2 of the application, the variance application, one of the reasons that was put forth by the Webster Trust was that the configuration of the lot and amount of frontage did not lend itself to residential development. And the best use of the property that was proposed, which at the time was for it was, I'd say, a rehab, a pediatric rehab for children with disabilities that would involve horses and animals, and I think there was going to be a barn and maybe more horses on site. That was the sort of proposed use that this variance was being sought for. The Webster Trust said the best use of the property would be as proposed, in keeping with the mixed use of the neighborhood. And on section B, the property is situated in an area that has residential, medical, and educational facilities, services. That's that has been the reality of this district for a long time. If the property is rezoned institutionally, or the district is rezoned institutionally, single-family houses are still permitted. It doesn't change the use of the properties that are in this district. They can still maintain single-family homes in the district. For your reference, I've included in tab 3 and 4, the uses permitted under institutional and also under the RM classification. As a mixed, not necessarily because of its mixed use, but the traffic at this stretch of Pleasant Street and Route 229 sees is a lot. It sees approximately 9,000 cars a day. During the peak hours in the morning and at night, it sees between 710 cars and 790 cars per hour. 710 cars is 12 cars a minute. This room doesn't hold 700 people, it holds about 100 people. So 7 of these rooms per hour comes down through that stretch of road during the peak hours in the morning and at night. If you think of 12 cars per minute, the rows are about 6 people a row. Every minute you're sending 2 rows down that street, every minute during the busy hours. Traffic will get worse, whether it's rezoned or not. And that's something that is in Mr. Mack's memorandum, which is at tab 6. By the year 2035, which is the year that we are asked to sort of use as a bookmark for projections for traffic and other studies, the estimate is that 700 cars an hour will be 1,200 cars an hour. And the 9,000 cars a day will be 12,000 cars a day in 17 years. There's a reason for that. This city has classified this road as a minor arterial. If you look at tab 8, which is an excerpt of the master plan, and you go to Roman VI, the classification is there, and it's a minor arterial street. Pleasant Street, Hopkinton Road between Langley Parkway and the Hopkinton Town Line. If you look at tab 8, Roman page before, Roman VI-4, a minor arterial generally carries traffic between 8,000 and 16,000 cars a day. That's what it's meant to carry. That's the volume it's designed to carry.